Hello, Libra. Welcome back to your part two. I'm sorry the previous video cut off. We were just getting out of the Energy Oracle cards. You received Cornucopia, and I had picked up the tarot, and the video cut off. So this is the tarot portion, okay, of the part one reading. So we'll label this reading part two. The Ten of Sticks came out as soon as the video cut off. This is what those envious enemies, these people, thought that you were going to take on that burden, that pain of whatever loss occurred. They thought you were going to just eventually succumb, I'm hearing, to the burden. I don't know how you would succumb to that. It's very negative, they're thinking. But alas, instead, you receiving this card is about that burden finally being lifted. Loads being lifted, knowing when to ask for help, learning to delegate responsibilities, focusing more on self-care, and taking a day off. Libra, I mean, they're mad because you can take a day off. Also, they're mad because you're in emperor mode. We have John Horse at the bottom, emperor. I'm hearing the accuracy again is significant. You're on point. You're on target for continued success. See, spam calls, just see anything that tries to disturb the energy or the message, we're not having it. Hey, welcome to the good life. Yes, Libra. Woo-wee. Six times six. Six of coins times six of baskets. Okay. Something you did in your past life or in your past in this life, you are being richly rewarded for now. We're coming very, very soon, is what I just heard. Coming very soon to a city or town near you. In all seriousness, this six of coins shows an ancestor rubbing a lucky $2 bill on their palm. If your palms have been itching, Libra, you can feel it in the air. You can feel it on your physical avatar. This cornucopia, this abundant harvest, these blessings. This is good fortune. If you've been seeing 7-Eleven consistently like me, cornucopia number 11, it's definitely about something you did in either your past, even childhood in this life, or your past life, because the Six of Cups is usually my past life card. One more. Thank you so much, Spirit. One more message for Libra. And then we'll end this reading off with my channeled messages deck. Top card. Yes! I can't tell no lies. I cannot tell a lie. Wow. And look who's back. He came out in our live stream the other day. If you haven't already watched that, your October predictions. It was a pretty good live stream. If you haven't checked that out, go check that out. That was my last live. This grandfather or father figure or great-grandfather figure is protecting you. More of that emperor energy coming through again. These people could envy your protection as well. Message. Not only do they envy the golden light energy, the cornucopia, your good fortune, your good karma Libra self, they envy your protection that you have otherworldly. Otherworldly protection. Libra, look what you just received. Ace of coins. Like, stop it. Stop it. Spirit is blessing us so abundantly. Libra. The Ace of Pentacles. This is a gift. I just heard a gift you deserve. Receiving money or gifts. New financial or career opportunities. Job offers. Abundance. Achieving tangible results. Blessings. Lottery winners. That's double confirmation, especially with it coming out right after the Six of Coins. You see that dice? That could be maybe take a gamble. Play that lottery. Play your numbers. Play those tickets, Libra. I'm not promoting gambling, but if you play a small amount on a consistent basis, don't stop now. Keep doing it. I'm hearing do it, do it. Achieving tangible results, blessings, lottery winners, optimism, money, reward for hard work. What did I say? Improved health, happy new beginnings, having a support system, manifestation, windfalls, and good omens. Oh my gosh. Six of Coins. Charitable giving. We talked about that in part one. Charitable giving, being generous. I literally said being generous. Debt repayment, grants, scholarships, philanthropy for the Six of Coins we're reading now. Fairness, receiving money owed, earning extra money. Equality. That's wild. You guys, you know I read for all ethnicities, all across the world. Interesting, the meditation music stopped suddenly. In part one, it was so interesting to me because I pointed out that in the woman holding a coin, there's a Caucasian woman with a black cat. And in the Nine of Coins, in the Hoodoo Tarot, it showed an African-American woman holding a white cat. And I was like, what is this? Is so wild. Like, I never noticed this. This has never come up before. But this is about equality as well. Mentoring, helping others, and those who care about the community. Yep, and I'm hearing it again. I don't know if that's Michael Jackson. I'm hearing Michael Jackson. Doesn't matter if you're black or white. I keep hearing him say that. I don't even know if that's him that says that in a song. I hope so, because I keep hearing his voice. Okay, wow, Libra. Wow. Look at that. Belief is the most powerful force in our universe. Let's go. Ending message for Libra. Ending message for Libra. Almost. Oh, Libra, the light. Light bulb moment, positive vibes, good energy, my friends. This cornucopia. At the bottom, the tables turn. I'd like three channeled messages for Libra. Okay, I'm hearing just two. Just two. Okay. Travel, go, freedom, movement. That's right, Libra. That's right. You do. You move with the light. Keep doing so. Stay abundantly blessed. Stay balanced. Until next time, thank you so much. Give me a big thumbs up. Sorry the first video cut off, but I did provide you with the part two. I instantly did what I needed to do with the camera and started into part two before I lost the energy. You know what I mean? Okay. Or the motivation or whatnot. Libra, thank you. Stay balanced. Stay blessed. Peace. Abundantly blessed. You move with the light. confirmation with the doggos barking in the background. 10:03 on the timer.